Morning, good morning, good morning. Father, we shake hands. Good morning, everyone. So you want to drop your prayer request and begin to chat your like and share. Go ahead and tag someone. Go ahead and tag someone. Happy Monday, everyone. Happy Monday. So we lift you high, and we lift you high, Yahweh, Yahweh, and we lift you high, Yahweh. Gonna wait for the man of God to come on. There he is. Good morning, good morning. I'm adding you now, Minister Wayman. You should see something that come up, may say connect. Go ahead and click on connect if it says so. It disappeared. Minister Wayman, it says no answer from you, so I don't see you up there at the top anymore. Make sure you logged on to True Destiny. I see you, but I say you're not answering. Make sure you click connect. I'm trying to add you again. Say no answer from the live video guests. There you go. Let's see. Try it again. It says adding. It says it's adding on my end, so if it comes up on your phone to accept, make sure you hit accept. I'm not sure what it says on your end. What does it say on your end? If it said anything on your end, let me know. Make sure you look for it, and it should say adding or connecting. It says no answer from the live video. Let me try it again. Went away again. Make sure you're online. You're on. Check your connection. I see you watching, but I don't see you up at the top anymore. We'll bring you on again. It says adding. There we go. Good morning. How you doing today, man of God?
I'm doing all right. Happy. How you doing?
I'm great, great. Happy Monday. Praise the Lord. Well, blessings, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our 6 a.m. morning, Monday morning glory prayer with Minister Wayman Lane. I want you to start, before we get started, I want you to go ahead and like and share this broadcast and tag someone. Let them know that we're on the line and we're going to be ministering the word of God and just sharing the word of God, rather, and also praying for others. If you have a special prayer request, go ahead and chop that name, those names down, or whatever the case may be, and whatever your needs are, and we will be praying for it at the end of the broadcast. Before we get started, I'm going to open up a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank and praise you, Lord God, for who you are. We bless you, Lord God, for waking us up this morning. Thank you for a beautiful, another sunshiny day on a Monday morning, a day that someone has not had the opportunity to wake up to, but you allow us to wake up this morning to glorify your name. We thank you, Lord God, that the words are said today, Lord God, that it encourages the people's heart, help them to go about their daily tasks today on Monday and all week long. Thank you for the man of God that took opportunity to, in his busy schedule, to come and join us in this broadcast this morning, just to deposit a word to us. So we thank and praise you, Lord God, for what you're doing and what you're going to do through him. In Jesus' name, amen. What I want to do is, before we get started, I want to read a scripture God laid on my heart this morning. And it comes from a simple scripture. Ephesians 6 is a familiar passage for us. And it's talk about the whole armor of God. And I'm just going to read a couple of passages. It just says, verse 10, Ephesians 6, verse 10 says, "Finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness in this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand, stand therefore. I'm going to stop right there, and I thank God for his word. I know the man of God may have God may laid on his heart, and but this just got dropped in my spirit. And I just want to bring on Minister Wayman Lane, and he can give us a brief excerpts about himself, and also just tell us what God placed on his heart and today, and what's going on today in this in our land, and we'll go from there. Minister Wayman, the floor is now yours.
Yes, hello everybody. How y'all doing? My name is Minister Wayman Lane. Pretty much ace jack of all trade. You know, I fabricate my own windows. I fabricate window screens, sliding glass doors, sliding screen doors. I do roofing. I pull curbs, sidewalks, pretty much whole nine yards. And, I had to do a 360 with my wife because, you know, I wasn't doing the best of my life at the time. Then plus God gave me a couple warning signs. So I had to do something about it. I had to step to the plate.
Amen, amen, amen. And so it sounds to me that you're in a home improvement, you know, like I won't say a contractor, but home improvement person that God. And that's awesome to know, because those that are watching and those that will be watching, if you need a home improvement, gentlemen, Minister Wayman is the man to call. And I just thank God for that, because he has done a lot of work for us in our home and also at the church. And so it's a blessing to have someone around that's reliable and dependable and that can do the job efficiently. Well, Mr. Wayman, tell us how what God is speaking to you about his word this morning. What is he saying to you to encourage the people of God, to encourage us?
I like what you were saying about the suit of armor. And we almost wear a suit of armor. We almost encourage each other to continue to wear a suit of armor. We have to keep each other prayed up. And, you know, we just have to keep each other encouraged, period. You know, for sister or brother down, you know, call our sister and brother and check on them. You know, just drop a line and say, hello, I was just concerned to see how you were doing. But we have to stay encouraged, especially when we are walking in our faith journey. Because when you don't have faith, when you lose the faith, then you pretty much lost everything. The devil pretty much defeated you. So, you know, God give us this power where we keep other encouraged and continue to get each other encouraged in the faith. You know, sister, how you going? I see you down a little bit. Let's pray about this thing. Or my brother, let's pray about this thing. We got to keep each other uplifted.
That's true. Yeah, we have to encourage each other. And that's what it's about, us encouraging each other in the body of Christ. Because like you said, a lot of people are down. They may not tell you. They may not tell you that they're down. They may not tell you they're going through something. But it's important that, like you said, that we don't have to know their personal issue. We just got to know that everybody needs encouraging. You know, and the ministers need encouraging, and everyone, because you know it's we live in a society where things are happening. I'll give you a brief testimony, real quick. We left church yesterday, on Broward Boulevard. Pastor and I, we witnessed a horrific accident, right up there before we got to Walmart. And the guy, you know, he speed right by us, leaving the church. And right up ahead of us, he crossed the lane and ran into a car, and the car ran into almost hit Krispy Kreme building. And so we stopped and tried to render service, and the guy who got hit was pinned under the steering wheel. And Pastor and another gentleman that was in line at Krispy Kreme, they helped him get out, and I called 911, and the guy who did the hitting, the younger guy, He jumped out the car. You could tell his adrenaline was going, but it was just a matter of life is so important. You never know when you'll be here today and gone tomorrow. That's why it's important that we pray for safety and pray for our lift up one another and pray for each other, because
how things are going in our life. You don't never know. You never know. So we cannot afford to take things for granted. And so, and Minister Wayman, I know you had an experience some years back. And can you give us a little quick testimony about how life, how God saved you from destruction?
Yes, but first I want to go back to encouragement first. Okay. Especially us as parents, we need to pay attention to our younger folks more, our kids, because our kids are getting in so much trouble nowadays, and we got to keep them uplifted and encouraged as well, not just the other people, but you know, it starts in the household. And you have to keep the kids uplifted. If you don't keep the kids uplifted, then you got to talk to them too like you talk to the other people. Because if you don't talk to them, they go and get out in gangs. They go get into the gun violence. They want to steal. They want to rob. They want to sell dope. You got to let them know that fast money ain't everything. That fast money can cause them their lives. And it can cause them lives one or two ways. It can cause them their life in prison. It can cause them to get killed. You know, and not only that, you're taking someone else's life. And not about me, in 96, I was in a bad accident. I was coming home from work. I was on the back of a dump truck. And the truck was a little overweight. And then when the guy shifted, he shifted fast, which caused the truck to jackknife. And it started slingshotting people. And I was one of the ones. I was like, Lord, let me live to see my kids again. So I wrapped my hand up in the truck, and the truck just swung me backwards and forth. And then when it did start to flip, I tried to jump, but I got pinned up under the truck. I had a big hole in the back of my head. From 96 to 2000, like 2000, right when I started by walking again. You know, it was horrific. I mean, I couldn't even put my own clothes on. My kids had to help me put my clothes on. I couldn't really bathe myself about the first 6 months. The first 6 months, I pretty much were helpless. And, you know, I had to have skin graft, had to have plastic surgery. You know, this part of my man, Boo, right here was ripped off. You know, it was just horrific. But I never wouldn't give up. You know, and I remember when the people were trying to get me to stay overnight, even though I was real beat up, real bad. I was a single parent then. I told the doctor that, I said, I can't stay here. And they was like, why? So I got to go home to my kids, you know. And so they were saying, don't you have someone to get to your kids? I said, but ain't no parent like you. And they had skin graft on my shoulder, my hip, my arm. Couldn't walk. It used to take me about an hour to walk from my room, maybe 2 hours from my room, just to the front door. You know, I couldn't hold a cup in my hand. I tried to hold a cup, and the cup just started shaking real bad. I couldn't hold it. Went through several different surgeries. But look at my me now. God bless. God bless me. I'm a new creature. Look at me now. Though.
Yes.
You know, those were some of the eye openers that made me do a 360 on my life. Then I turned around after that. Then I had counseling. You know, scariest thing of my life at first. Then I always thought about what my grandma said, God will put them on you than you can bear. You know, so yes. I went into the little war room, saved my little prayer when everybody was gone, had time to focus on God. Then God said, don't worry, I got you. I've changed person ever since.
Amen. You know, one thing you said, man of God, many things you said, but I hear you're a miracle walker. You're a walking miracle, because it's a lot of people. God had, you could tell God had you on his side. God had you in his hands. No matter when the enemy tried to take you out. And that's how a lot of people, they take so many chances, and they don't recognize that God has them in the palm of their hand, his hands. And the mere fact you said that how you began to acknowledge God, change your life around. You know, nobody's perfect, but you recognize who had you. And so that's what I think younger people generation don't realize, how they are so fortunate that God have them and somebody's praying. Because I know somebody had been praying for you.
Somebody had been praying for me. I had a praying grandmother. I got a call from a praying family.
Awesome.
Even though you have a praying family, you got to know what's going on within you. And I used to tell my wife, the scenery was just different. I just tell my wife, I say, I got to go to church. You got to get in some kind of good church. I remember I had it so bad, I would ride the bicycle to the church. I had a car, had two cars. But, you know, until I found that right one, until I found that right church, you know, then that's when I settled. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and what's important, I think, is when we acknowledge God. Listen, you ran after God no matter what. For a person to ride the bike, and you hear those that are watching, and though they'll be watching, the man of God rode a bike to church. He could have took a bus, but his heart was running after God, and his heart was desperate for the things of God. Until I can hear him saying, "No matter the cost, no matter what it takes, I'm gonna go after God." And go ahead, man of God. I'm sorry.
No. I was just saying, just like that song say, no matter what, no quit, just fight to the end, push to the end. It was times that I could have gave up, but there's no quit in my blood. Never was quit in my blood. I always just say a prayer. Even in the morning when I get up, like from the accident, I'd be real stiff. I just say, Lord, give me the strength to make this day. Give me the strength to carry on with this journey. You know, just got to put your little prayer in first and keep it moving, keep it pushing.
That's good, and that's called, I like that, because it's called focus. You're focused on not where the pain is at, not where the situation had took place, but you focus on the future, focus what God can do. And that's what we need to now. That's what our new people, our new the babies in Christ, and the ones that the babies that's getting to know the Lord, and ones that need to know the Lord, that's what they need to know. Stay focused on the man of God gets on roof, he does roofing, and that's a task by itself. And for him to say that he had an injury such as that and still could get on a roof and repair your roof and do things, work that require physical work, that's a blessing all by itself, because the enemy tried to take him out. But God said no. God said no. You know, Minister Wayman, let us tell and encourage the people out there that when how to stay focused. Like you say, I believe you're focused. You're laser focused on what God has told you to do. Encourage the men, and especially our younger generation, our younger men, how to stay focused, laser focused on the task ahead.
Well, you know, I tell my kids all the time, you know, you have to get your priorities right. And during that time, my priorities wasn't right. So, you know, I started focusing on me and I started focusing on God. It's a tough task because I had got back into the world. And when you're in the world, the devil throw a lot of things at you to get you, you know, get your attention. So you got to block the world out and then let God come into the heart. And when I say you got to block the world out, it ain't easy giving up the world. And I'm not going to sit here in front of everybody and tell everybody I'm this perfect saint. I'm not this perfect saint. You know, we all have our ups and downs and our issues that we deal with.
Right.
But you just have to open your heart and be willing to accept God and put God first. You even have things that pop up on Facebook and stuff where people try to tempt you and all kind of stuff. You out there in the world, people do things that try to tempt you. Sometimes you have to cut back from different friends. You know, the Bible tells you, you'll lose friends behind it. I deal with a lot of older guys. I actually have friends that encourage me. I actually have friends tell me, saying, hey, man, you're doing a heck of a job. I appreciate that. Instead of me looking up to them, by they way older than me, they look up to me. You know, I don't thrive off of, but I always try to get them a word of encouragement. Like I might pull up and they'll just say, hey man, talk with me about something. Sometimes as I go to the store, as you know, I met a young man that came to the church several times. Sometimes I get the people and I tell them, I say, hey, do y'all know about God? You know, we sit there and we'll talk about God, you know. I try to tell them, hey, you know, it ain't got to be my church, but find a church, you know, find a Bible-based on my church, you know. Try to find your church that not only when they read the scriptures, they can try to break it down to you.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's a little tough, but you just got to keep pushing. You know, you can't. I look at it like this, you know, nothing from nothing, you get nothing. So you just got to keep pushing. You got to keep pushing. You got to keep fighting to the end, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, you're going to get victory because God going to see that you get the victory.
That's right. Absolutely. Yes, you got to keep fighting. Don't throw in the towel. Don't give up. It's easy to give up, but it takes a true warrior. A true a person that's really, really fighting the good fight of faith, the word tells us, to not give up, to not throw in that towel. And that's what we have to learn to encourage, I believe, keep continuing encouraging our young people, our young generation, even the older ones that don't seem to know the way to encourage them in the things of God. And just telling us, listen, it's not going to always be like that. It's not going to always be so bad. It's not going to always be, you know, the circumstance. Not going to, don't go by what it looks like, but stay laser focused on what God is doing in your life. Go ahead.
Okay, I'm sorry. You can go ahead. Then I'll come back. Me and my cousin, we was talking last night, and everybody be like, CMB, I'm my brother keeper. Okay, if you're a brother keeper, why you can't be a brother keeper of the Lord? If you want a real, I'm gonna be my brother keeper, and a person ain't gonna never turn their bike on you. See, the brothers that saying they my brother keeper, they gonna turn their bike on you. But the real brother's keeper is the Lord Himself. Someone will never turn their bike on you. Someone will be there for you all time. Someone you have a shoulder to cry on, someone you can talk to, someone gonna uplift you, someone on your feet down, somebody gonna take your feet up out the ground and put it on solid ground. So if you're gonna be a brother's keeper, be a brother keeper for the Lord.
That's right. We all are brother's keeper, and we are, and like you said, we need to be encouraging for the Lord and not it's listen, when a person feel like they're distraught. Or they're going through so much calamity because there's a lot of stuff going on around us. We need to remember that to be our brother by just encouraging them. You don't have to preach to them. You don't have to badger them or bang them on the head, but just encourage them. Give them a word of encouragement. And I believe that's what you're doing. That's why people are, God send people your way and for you to encourage them, because I believe God will prepare the people's heart before you go to them. To say, hey, and you always give us testimony how you could be in a store anywhere and people just look on you and they just draw to you, they gravitate to you, and it's because the Spirit of the Lord that's on the inside of you. They see something. They may not know what it is, but they see something. But we know it's the Holy Ghost. But they see something inside of you that allows them to just talk and share, and that's important. You're relatable. Put it that way. You could be relatable.
Yes. But you know, it's amazing, like, when you tell people your testimony, you know, some people realize, they got stuff worse than you. And that's why it's important when you tell your testimony, you tell it truthfully, wholeheartedly. Because you never know what a person going through. So when you tell that testimony, and they be like, wow. You know, they might not show it right then when they get home. They be like, wow. You know, I thought I went through some things. I thought I was going through some things. I thought I might have gave up, but now I hear this word, I won't give up. Now I'll fight to the end. Like the young lady, she was telling me she had cancer. And I was telling her, I said, hey, fight to the end. You know, don't give up. And, you know, I was telling her about my situation. And I was telling her, I said, you know, God used people all different caliber. And I said, you don't look like a crook. I said, look at Paul. He was a murderer. And I told about Noah. I told about how God used the alcoholics, how he used people that even of this world nowadays that was on drugs or whatever. I said, you just gotta keep fighting, keep fighting, keep fighting. So now when the young lady see me, she be like, wow, thank you. I really needed to hear that. Every time she come this way. She'll stop right there, her and her husband, they'll talk to me. I tell my wife, I said, I'm going to go across the street and holler at these peoples over here. So, and talk, we talk, I give a word of encouragement. She give me a word of encouragement. But see what they fail to realize, when you get in word of encouragement and you see them doing good, it encourage you more to stay praying. It encourage you more to keep pushing more. It encourage you more to get up and do what you do.
Yes, I like that, and that's true. When you encourage someone, when you let you know that, hey, whatever you said, it's not in vain. And I think because when you encourage someone and you see that I'm doing better, and they encourage you, and you see a difference in their life, it encourages you because you say, okay, yeah, I thank God that what I said and helped them along the way. You just plant the seed,
Right. Iron sharpening iron. That's right. It's iron sharpening iron. And the thing is though, but you can't take the glory for that. I don't take the glory for that. Right. I just say thank God that you gave me the proper words to say to the young lady. If I'm talking to a gentleman or whatever, thank God that you gave me the proper words to say to that gentleman. It's just like when you get up on the pulpit, you ask God to let you decrease and he increase. So you just have to thank God for giving you the proper stuff to say. Don't try to take the props for something God did. God just uses you to get through that person. That's what it was. It wasn't me that did it. It was God that came through me to tell the person what to say.
That's right. We don't get the glory for. I like that. We do not get the glory. We are not trying to get the glory. God's glory. That's God's glory. And the Holy Ghost just uses us as we minister. I do have several prayer requests, and one of them is someone inbox me and say, pray for the, I guess something, I didn't catch the news about the fire with the kids. They say 19 people died and 9 of them was kids in New York. And pray for the families, and then pray for we're gonna pray for Brother Corey, and those that are out there dealing with the COVID. They were talking about the other day. They were talking about how they think 90% of Floridians, people in Florida, are gonna catch COVID. That's big. Yeah. That's a big thing. God has the last say. That's what man say. But we're going to continue to pray. Then I have someone named Gloria inbox me and ask for prayer. Gloria, I don't know what their situation is. They said that pray for her and her family. She said pray for her and her family that's going through something. And then I have a prayer from a Nina that said pray for financial. For her finances. So we're going to go before I want you to pray for those, if you can remember them. We're going to pray for the people that have COVID, Floridians, the children and the families that got killed in New York from a fire. And then we just pray as God leads. Amen. Go ahead and go before the Father and pray for me.
Father God, we come to you this morning with peace and humbleness, Father. Father, we ask you to put a hedge of protection around this world as we go through this moment of this COVID, Father. We ask you to ask the people, we ask you to let the people get their shots if needed. Those that don't want to get the shot, we still ask you to keep a hedge of protection around them. Father, we ask you to bless our jobs. We ask you to bless our homes. And Father, we ask you, if the person is down, we ask you to uplift them. We ask you to bless us financially, physically, and spiritually. Father, we just ask you to pour your mercy and your grace down on us now, Father. Father, we uplift this world, Father. We're in a world of turmoil where we really need you, Father. We need you to come through, Father. Father, uplift this family with the 9 kids. was deceased in this fire, Father. Father, we ask you to bless this family that was down the street where the five kids got hit by the car, Father. Father, we just ask you to help up and bless us now, Father. Father, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we ask you to just put a change in our life. Just touch our hearts. Touch our souls. Father, we ask you to come through right now, Father. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let me just continue that prayer. Father, I pray for Nina that submitted a prayer request and the young lady that submitted a prayer request that need family for a prayer for her home, Lord God, her family, Lord God. We thank and praise you, Lord God, that your will be done. We don't know everything, but you know all things, God. But God, we pray, Lord God, that you meet her need, meet her wherever they are, Lord God. We pray for Brother Corey that's going to go into surgery this week, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, strengthen him, Lord God, strengthen and keep him, Lord God. Lord God, that he have a smooth recovery in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We pray for our True Destiny Ministries Church family, Lord God. Touch them, Lord God. They ask that you go with them, be with them, Lord God, wherever they be, Lord God. We decree safety, Lord God, over their life, Lord God. We declare and decree, Lord God, that they walk in your word, Lord God. We declare and decree, Lord God, the safety of God, your angels shall camp around them and keeping them, Lord God. We pray for Pastor Dwight as he on his way to work, Lord God. Give him safety, Lord God, that he goes in. Get there safely, Lord God. Let no hurt, harm, or danger come near him, Lord God. All those kids that's in school, Lord God, we pray for the blood of Jesus, Lord God, over his vehicle, Lord God, and no hurt, harm, or danger, no COVID, Lord God, should come near him, or the administrators, or the teachers, or the students, God. We pray, Lord God, we decree and declare, your will be done, Father. Now, as Minister Wayman goes to work, Lord God, we pray for safety on his life. Lord God, cover the, replete the blood of Jesus. Cover him with your blood, Lord God. Lord God, that no hurt, harm, or danger shall come near him, Father. And we thank and praise you, Lord God, what the enemy meant for evil for him and his family. You've already, Lord God, turned around for his good. We thank and praise you, Lord God, for each and every person that may be experiencing difficulties right now. They're saying, God, I don't see a way. I don't know. I don't have a way. I don't know what's going on. I don't understand. But God, we pray right now in the name of Jesus, give them clarity, God. Give them understanding, Lord God, what they're going through, Lord God. Yes. But most of all, they seek you first, as Matthew 6:33 says, and seek your kingdom, Lord God, and everything they desire or want or need shall be added unto you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Father, what you're doing and what you're going to do. We decree and declare your supernatural blessing is going to come upon us, Lord God, because of your word, because of being obedient to you, Father. We thank you for a financial breakthrough that's going to be on our life. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. And you know what, man of God, I was thinking, I said, God, I thank you because it's so important. I believe it's so important that we, like I read earlier, we do put on the armor of God. Mm-hmm. We do continue. And the armor is to protect us from the things that we prayed against. The armor is for that. And I'm going to read an excerpt from that again. It says, be strong in the Lord. Yes. Be strong in the Lord, it says, and the power of his might. We got to remain strong to put on that armor. Mm-hmm. To put on that armor of God that we may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Because we're going to need that armor to stand.
Yes. And you definitely need that breastplate because, see, the devil knows if he can kill the heart, he got you. Mm. See, a lot of people fail to realize it's your heart what's defiled you. Now, once you start thinking it, you process, you committing it already, but it's your heart. Your heart got to remain pure. So you got to keep that breastplate on. You got to keep your head going. You got to stay prayed up. You just got to continue to ask God to continue to give you that strength. You know, like I say, it's not an easy task. You got to just ask God for the strength. You got to put your gear on. And you got to get out. Mm-hmm. Say your prayer. I tell people all the time, once I say my prayer, when I get on my knees and I say my prayer, once I say my prayer, I get up, I'm ready for a walk.
That's right.
Even when
That's,
I play,
I like
even
that.
when
I
I
like
play
that.
sports,
I like that.
even when I
I
play
like that
sports,
you just said.
I always say
I'm
a
sorry,
prayer.
go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. You
No,
say a
I was
prayer.
just saying,
And you have to.
even when I play sports, I always say the prayer first. You got to put God before everything, you know. And I
That's
just
right.
asked for a beautiful wife. So God gave me a beautiful wife. So you got to put God before anything, you know. He said, if you ask, you'll receive. You know, if you seek,
Yes.
you'll
Yeah.
find. So, you know, so
That's right.
like I say, I get on my knees and I pray. Once I get off the knees and pray, or sometimes I just might just lay there in the bed and pray. But once I say my prayer, I'm ready for battle. I'm ready for
That's
whatever.
it.
I'm
I like
geared
that.
up. I'm ready to go.
I like that because you just highlighted verse 12 where it says, "We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, powers, against the rulers of darkness in this age." So you said one important thing, and everybody, I hope you heard what he just said through the Spirit. He said once he get up for prayer, he's ready for battle. So he acknowledged that prayer came first. We must pray. We can't fight this thing in our flesh. So he acknowledged he got to go before the Father first to prepare him for the battle.
Yes,
yeah, you don't
yes.
go. You know, you can't go to. You can't go back. You can't go to the battle without you being trained. So he went to the
That's
training
right.
ground, and that's it.
That's it. Just
I
like
like
with
that. I
leadership,
like that.
you gotta be molded. You gotta be molded. You gotta be mentored. You know, you gotta be
Yes.
taken up on the. Someone got to take you up under the wings and teach. You know. But when someone take you up on their wings, you can't be rude. You know, you gotta act like you got good home training, and then let God just do His thing. You know, because some of us don't like orders. You know, so you know, you just have to put your little pride to the side. You know, and accept whatever knowledge God get that person to get to you, let them mentor you. You know, in order
That's
to be a good
true.
leader, you
That's
got to be
true.
able to receive orders. So you know, all that come with the territory. Oh, that come with the
Come with the
territory.
territory. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, man of God, I thank God that you joined me this morning. I think it was an awesome, awesome study. Awesome, encouraging. But this was very phenomenal because it was, listen, and I always say we don't need to be yelling, screaming, prophesying, telling folk for money to get a word. No, we just going to share. We share the simple thing because this is a We're living in this world. This is a simple life. People don't need all that hoopla. They don't need all that drama. They just need, hey, listen, how do I get to the next day? How do I get to the next hour? How do I get from here to there? And that's what we're here to do, to tell you just basic principles, how to get through. How to get through, how we did. That's what I thank God.
How will God say, spread the good news, spread His word, you know? And so that's basically what we're doing. We're spreading the good news.
That's right.
We're carrying
That's right.
God's word.
That's right.
You know,
so. Now, my husband and I, we thank God for each and every week, every day that He placed you and your wife in our ministry, in our lives, because we're a team, and we just thank God that how as a team, you know, we team players, and we God just placed us, and it was like a niche, like a you ever seen a knit. They're just knit together. Now we just carrying it. It's about kingdom building. And we're building the kingdom of God for His glory. Well, do you have anything you want to say before we close out in prayer?
No, it's definitely a journey, you know. Me and my wife, we appreciate y'all. You know, it's a learning experience. We learning as we go. You know, so. We appreciate it. We appreciate all the prayers that people give us. You know, we just take it one day at a time. And
Amen.
You know,
Amen.
And we thank God for putting y'all in our life. Yes.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. You know, I always say, listen, we haven't been pastors for no 20 years or 30 years, and you know, raised in a pastor's house, and you know, it's a learning curve, a learning experience for us as well. And you know, that's why we rely on the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, to lead and guide us. And so, you know, God said, as long as we obedient to Him, He will give us the direction that we need to go in. And that's what we believe. If we're going to be obedient to Him, no matter what, you know, no matter what. And
Yes.
I just thank, once again, I thank God for you joining me this morning on our broadcast. Listen, those of you who are watching, I want you to share, like, and share this broadcast, because I believe it's going to encourage someone later on our social, on our YouTube channel. And if you have not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, please do so. Go to YouTube, True Destiny Ministry, and just click the subscribe button. And before we dismiss, I want to once again thank Minister Wayman Lane for joining us. If you need someone, need his services, he's a great home improvement, and he'll let you know what he can and cannot do. How can they reach you, Minister Wayne?
Well, they can reach me at
754-801-2574. Okay. 2574.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So you heard
I'm good
that.
At I'm good at what I do, and I have pride in what I do. I've been doing this type of work since I was about 6 years old with my dad and my uncles them. So. Bring it on. Amen.
Yes, he is. So you're at 754-801-2574. If you need a handyman to or a home improvement guy to come and do some work for you, yes. He you can let him know. He'll let you know his availability. And you know, it's about helping each other, helping one another. It's a lot. Listen, it's hard to find people out there these days that want to work. Put it that way, that want to work. And so just go ahead and if God lives in your heart, go ahead and contact him. The number is there on the screen, and it'll be on the broadcast. It'll be on our YouTube channel for later, those that are going to watch later. So go ahead and give him a call. That way you can get work done if you need it. Once again, let's pray. Thank you, man of God, for allowing your for opportunity out of your busy schedule to come in and minister to us. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank and praise you once again, Lord God, for the man of God that came forth and poured out his testimony, gave us the words of encouragement. Lord God, and gave us a powerful prayer, Lord God, praying for our nation, praying for those that are around us. God, we pray right now for restoring his life, Lord God. Lord God, in anything that he's lacking, Lord God, I know he's not lacking, Lord God, but you continue to fill his baskets, Lord God. Overflow, Lord God. We speak oil in his life, Lord God. Lord God, give him an overflow blessing, God. We thank and praise you, Lord God, that he shall not want for anything here in his family. Lord God, we thank you for health and strength in his life. God, we thank you, Lord God, that the oil of the Holy Ghost shall flow from his head like it did from Aaron's beard all the way down to his life, Lord God. And we thank and praise you for what you're doing and what you're going to do in Jesus' name. Amen. Once again, you guys, thank you for tuning in today. We love you. We appreciate you. Until we speak again, God bless you. See you on Wednesday night at 7:30. Take care. God bless. Good.
Yes.
Have a good day.
You too, Lil.
God bless.